three laps for the Grand Prix of Europe coming up in Moto3. Eyes to the lights. And away we go in Moto3. A good solid start there from John McPhee and Celestino Vietti, like a rocket down the start finish straight. Arenas also with a good start.
It was a wretched start for John McPhee. Came to the first sector down in ninth place from pole.
Is that McPhee? I think that's John McPhee.
And it is. That's game over for John McPhee now as well in the championship. Surely that is his own scorecard. Oh, how many times has John McPhee thrown away crucial world championship points this year? You catch your minds back to Styria, don't you? To Jerez, Andalusia. And that surely now is game over for McPhee.
Let's see what happened then to the number 17. There he is, just behind. I think he's got a damp patch, you know. There's a damp patch at turn one. The bike's on top of him and he's high-sided out of it. Massia's down and is now that the championship over him. We've got championship rivals dropping like flies here.
I think now you can say McPhee and Massia can forget the championship.
Aiguera would have to finish in second to get 20 points in order to take the championship lead.
With John McPhee out, Jaume Massia out, this is a wonderful opportunity now for Aiguera to really take control of the championship. And of course, Tony Arbolino, you can't discount him as well. He's fifth in the rankings at the moment. He wants to hang on to this precious 20 points as well.
Here comes Aiguera then. Is he now going to try and challenge Tony Arbolino? He cannot get close enough. Can Aiguera get himself into second place? Can he even get up the place at all? Is he going to be on the podium?
Aiguera behind him. Ruthless by Aiguera. That's brilliant. He's picked the pocket of Arbolino there at turn six. And as he snatched the podium late on here in Valencia.
Precious points here for both of these guys in the World Championship. One thing they cannot afford to do, of course, is end up in a gravel trap. Arbolino's really, really hungry here to try and challenge Aiguera again and find himself on the podium.
Coming into final sector.
Aiguera, I thought, was going to try and lunge here. And Aiguera is back on the podium and the championship is well alive. Massive for Vietti, and it almost wiped out Arenas. Lopez goes down with him.
And that's Vietti's world championship hope surely gone.
Watch this. This is Vietti then, high-siding out of turn four. Boom. He got clattered by Arenas Lopez.
Checked, didn't he? What happened was there, Vietti checked, Arenas checked.
Oh, blimey. So unfortunate. You know, Vietti was slightly offline because he'd been overtaken by Raul Fernandez.
How's your luck, Albert Arenas? Well, there's none of it. Oh, bang, look at that. He got lifted out of the seat. The impact was so big. You could see him there lifted out of the seat.
Albert Arenas has got a problem. He was clattered into there, Matt. Is he going to be out of the race?
There's smoke coming from his bike.
This is huge drama in Moto3. I think Albert Arenas is going to have to retire. He's coming into the pit lane. They're going to see if they can get that fixed and go out again, I'm sure, because otherwise it's all over. What drama in Moto3. We said he had a comfortable lead in the World Championship, and it's gone already. The live championship standings, Aiguera leads.
He's absolutely furious, livid. Incensed, as you would imagine. What a monumental swing this has been. Again, the pendulum swings back towards Aiguera.
Unbelievable. 2020. When are the stories going to stop? Well, he's going back out on circuit. They've got the bike fixed. Albert Arenas, as he lunges up the inside of Aiguera, who he's actually fighting with in the championship. He's three laps down.
Oh, guys, normally it's just not allowed. He is in the championship, so they might give him a little bit of leeway, but normally it's not allowed.
He's just gone ahead. Albert Arenas has got the gall here to tell Darren Binder, stick with me and I'll bring you to the pack. That says blue flag. He's being told to let Darren Binder through. So he's now being told by race direction, you've got to let him through.
He's picking fights here that he's not in.
And so ultimately, if he doesn't respect that shortly, he's going to be given a black flag. Black flag.
Yeah.
Black flag. Disqualified from the race, Albert Arenas. If Albert Arenas does not now respect this black flag and pull in, he might incur a penalty for next week.
Arenas then has come in. It's a big shake of the head from him. He wasn't going to be scoring any points. He was three laps down. But at the moment, he is still clinging on to the World Championship lead, which is incredible when you think.
Look at this as well, out front. The lead building here for Raul Fernandez. We don't see this very often in Moto3. As a result of that crash, he's 2 and a bit seconds clear. Keep tabs on this young man, Raul Fernandez, searching for his first ever Grand Prix victory. Raul Fernandez is doing a tremendous job here under pressure to just maintain this gap out front. Right now, he's comfortable. 1.5 seconds is fine with three laps to go. He's done a brilliant job What a win, a maiden victory for Raul Fernandez in Moto3. What a win though for the Red Bull KTM Iho rider. Brilliant, brilliant result for him. His second podium, his first win in Grand Prix racing.